So as any synthaholic will tell you, satisfying those cravings isn't always the easiest thing. It can leave you feeling a little bit on edge sometimes, let's say. And even then, you're still trying to spice things up. But before you can sprinkle the spice, you first gotta grind. Bet you didn't see this one coming. Over the years, we've been slowly adding to the Producer series, first with the Crave, and then last year we released the Edge. And it's a collection we're really excited to further expand, and what better way to add to an all-analog lineup than with this little unexpected gem, introducing Behringer GRIND. And what sets the GRIND apart is its unique hybrid semi-modular design. So while the other models are fully analog, the GRIND blends the best of both worlds with digital oscillators and an analog signal path, offering a super versatile sound palette capable of making anything from ripping leads, lush chords, ethereal pads, to crunchy percussion and thumping drums. And this is due to its formidable selection of 24 digital oscillator types, consisting of 10 different synth engines, 10 percussion and noise engines, and 4 extended engines, and still some room left for future expansion. Pretty cool. It's got multifunctional timbre, harmonics, and morph controls, allowing you to sculpt those wave shapes to perfection. And in the analog section, you've got that classic 24 dB ladder filter. I mean, you can never go wrong with a ladder filter, right? It's equipped with an envelope generator with attack, decay, sustain, a vibrato modulation control, LFO with square and triangle waves, there's the glide control, the multifunctional VC mix control, which can be used as either a voltage source or an attenuator, or even an extra VCA, or of course, a mixer. And let's not forget the performance-inspiring arpeggiator and sequencer with swing, the all-essential semi-modular patch bay, and it's got USB and DIN MIDI connections for hassle-free integration. Oh, and if you haven't clocked it yet, it is of course based on our popular Eurorack module, Brains. Okay, so let's now take a look at how these synth engines work with a few examples. So first thing we're going to want to do is reference the manual and look at the waveform parameters chart. And here we can see exactly what the timbre, harmonics and morph controls are assigned to within each engine, because for each one they will manipulate a different element. And it's also worth noting you've got a secondary oscillator output on the patch bay that gives you some alternative audio sources to play with. So lots of flexibility to be had. Okay, so here we're running the virtual analog engine, which is a dual oscillator with square and saw waves. So the timbre control, or should I say timbre for Americans, manipulates the square wave from being a narrow pulse to a full square and then to a hard sync performance. Harmonics control will detune one of the two oscillators, with 12 o'clock being the center position. Great for getting that fat detuned bass sound and adding other notes and octaves. We'll be right back. Control changes the saw wave from a triangle to a wide notch saw. Okay, very nice. So let's take a look at another one. Here we have the chords engine. So the timbre controls the chord inversions and transpose. Harmonics changes the chord type. Okay, so next up, let's check out some of the newer expansions. Here we've got the Bassline engine, which as you might have guessed is based on a TD3 inspired patch. And in this one, the timbre controls the low pass filter. And if we want more of that distinctive 303 punchiness, we can flick on the low pass gate. There we go. Control increases the envelope amount. The harmonics acts as the resonant. We can also do some interesting voicings with the high pass ladder filter. And you can also push the harmonics control even further to go into some nice bitey distortion. Okay, next up, we've got the BX7 engine, and this one is another really cool one. It's obviously a DX7 bank, and you can even upload a DX7 SysX file to change the onboard sounds. Pretty cool. So the timbre acts as a vibrato control. And can go up to crazy levels. The morph gives you a tremolo. Sounds nice. And with the harmonics, you can scroll through all the 32 sounds within this bank. Thank you. Alright, so I think we get the gist of how the synth engines work, and man, with 24 of them, there's literally thousands of different tones you can get out of it. Way too many to do it justice in a short promo video, but nevertheless, here's a couple of examples. Alright, so we're already 10 minutes in and have only just begun to scratch the surface of this really cool addition to the Producer series. But if you're interested to delve a bit deeper into the synth, we've got a few more videos you can check out where I do a full breakdown of how I produce the intro music you heard at the beginning of this video. There's also an extended demos video. And if you're interested in how the Grind blends with some of our other synths, there's a jam featuring the Grind, Crave, Edge, and RD6. And stay tuned to the channel, guys, because we've got some really cool synth releases coming soon. As always, keep synthing on. Catch you in the next one. Peace.